Hey gang, at Waukegan Airport, just got here. It is a beautiful VFR sunny day today. I'm gonna be flying up to Monaco, Wisconsin. And got a buddy coming along, David. Name's David Burton, and we're gonna be doing a little fishing. We got the fishing rods here, all the good stuff. And just driving out now to get all the stuff put in the airplane.
Morning, it's your signature.
Yeah, it's Ron at the gate. Could you buzz
me in?
All right, thanks. All right. Signature flight support. They're great. Everybody's friendly, supportive. They just you just tell they really enjoy what they do, take a lot of pride in it, and boy, it's just a pleasure. It's just really fun being out here working with those guys. All right, let's get our goodies packed. Looks like another little plane just came in. Hey, how you doing? What's going on?
Good.
You're on candid camera. Everything's set? Beautiful day?
Yeah, it really is.
Got the plane out? Thank you very much. Yeah, no, I'll be back probably on Friday afternoon, Friday midday.
Okay, thank you so much.
All right, see ya. Today I'm gonna show you a few of the preflight things we do on the Caravan. Okay, we got the clamshell door up here, and a couple of things we want to look at is just make sure the battery connection is good. Have a general look around. What you're looking at there is a jet engine, PT6. And everything looking pretty clean in here. So I'm just giving it a general look around. I want to see any fluids. I don't want to see any fluids spray or anything like that. You're kind of looking at connections. And everything looks very clean. Another thing we want to do is always check the oil, which I actually did yesterday, so we don't have to do that. But even though I checked it yesterday, there's a couple of other things we need to check. And make sure just before takeoff, because you just never know. And the first thing you want to do before each flight is just check all these fuses, make sure they're in. See here, there is a red button right up here, and if that pops up, see that popped up, that means that the filter stopped and all the fuel will go through a bypass, will not be filtered. So you want to make sure that is not up. I always put this on for the propeller in case they pull it out and it's really windy before I get here. Same with the gust lock on the yoke. We've got in the Caravan four compartments in the floats, two on each side, which are really handy, and there's actually a lot of space in here. Keep chocks and miscellaneous things in there. Cleaning materials, anything for my preflight. Gotta always make sure we close these. Hated those lines on there. Wanna make sure those lines line up. Checking the wheels. Make sure tire pressure looks good. Nothing foreign, nothing abnormal. I was checking the static wicks on the wings. That are these dissipates electricity if you're flying IFR especially. And you need to make sure those are all on and in okay shape. I think technically you can fly with up to two of them broken or gone. I did have a broken one this week that I replaced. Very easy, you just screw them on. Everything else looks good. You want to make sure that the rudder lock here is in the off position, unlock. All right. This connects to the yoke right there, and that prevents this from moving. Let's say it's out here parked on a windy day. Before I get out here, this thing would be all the flight controls. We don't want those flying all over the place. I'm gonna jump in and get that off. Good to see you.
Ready Look
to
at go? That bad boy.
Beautiful day.
Nice.
Yeah. We're looking good. Hi there. Nice. What's your name?
No, it's she's our au pair.
Oh, Miss Au Pair. Nice to meet you. What's your name?
She's from Austria. She's been with us for about a year.
Oh, wow. Right? What's your name?
Martina.
Martina. Nice. That sounds Russian. Is that
it's
German?
It's Italian.
Martina's Italian? Yeah. Are you from Italy?
No, Austria. And
you are from Austria.
To go home.
Oh, you brought the wheelchair.
Oh, nice.
No, they're bikes, I know.
She said, she's not ready to go home.
When are you going back? Are you, exchange right now, or just...
Yeah, kind of.
Cool.
Yeah, I'm going
cool.
back in August.
Cool.
And hit this little button. That'll give you sound masking. Alright, so we're gonna fire this jet engine up.
10 miles west of the field with a hotel now. Inbound.
Check our voltage.
Good pilot.
24.7, that's good. Emergency power level.
MSAT 467 Delta Charlie, you're at 2700, sir.
Boy area is clear.
What was that again? Can you repeat for some of the time?
Fuel boost is on.
MSAT 467 Delta Charlie, you're at 2600.
Yes, sir. Right. 2,000.
Starting sequence.
All right. Report 5 miles west out the field. Then expect a right base for runway 14.
Right base, runway 14. We'll report 5 miles west. 7 up the
Now we're watching the ITT right here. And no hot start and no hot start. So.
Helicopter 8350, Mike, Waukegan Tower. Say you're altitude, sir.
1,400 feet, heading up to the back of
the land. Waukegan Tower, information hotel.
Oh, this is our time, Zulu time.
Weather. Wind variable at 3, visibility 10. Sky condition, feet platform at 6,000. Temperature 2-1, dew point 8. Altimeters 2-9-9-6. ILS approaching use, landing runway 23. Read back all host short instructions and runway assignment.
So we'll be over there going that way.
Advise you information. Hotel.
Okay, it's Information Hotel. So we got the wind coming out of that, so we're going to taxi way down that way to take off that way. So now I'm going to contact ground and tell them that we're ready to go.
Information, Mike, Roger, free change through.
Information Hotel. Waukegan Ground 18 Sierra Foxtrot, signature northwest, and we do have hotel ready for taxi for departure.
Caravan 18 Sierra Foxtrot, from signature taxi to runway 23 via Mike 1 Alpha, hold short to runway 14.
Okay, Mike 1 Alpha will hold short of 14 Sierra Fox.
Caravan 8 Sierra Foxtrot, say your direction of departure.
Northwestbound 8 Sierra Foxtrot.
Director, you could cross runway 23, correction, cross runway 14 on Alpha.
Okay, on Alpha, we'll cross 14. So he just gave us permission to cross because that plane has now landed. Still look both ways. One time that I got clearance at Biggs Field to take off, and I look, and a plane was landing. We would have possibly had a collision. Would have been pretty bad. This plane has reverse, so right now I'm on, this is in high idle. I'm gonna hear the prop. Yeah, now it's pulling back, slowing us down. There's like a gate, so you pull this up. So now I'm back, you can feel it go forward a little. Pull these two up, bring it back beyond the gate. Right. It's great for on the water.
Yeah, right.
You hit reverse, though, that prop's not changing direction.
No, it's the angle. Blades are reversing.
Yeah, right.
Coyote?
Oh, yeah, right.
Small coyote? Mm-hmm. Yeah.
There is.
You can even hear it. The plane will naturally pull to the left. You got to account for that, and that's the torque. Torque of the propeller. Same for takeoff. You got to go right rudder. Make up for that. All right, there's one more preflight thing we have to do, and that's the RPM governor. Overspeed governor. So we hit this red button, which kind of sets the governor, and then we increase the RPM. We're going to watch this prop RPM. We don't want to go to 18. Shouldn't go. It'll stop around 1750, 1780. And that's doing as it should. So the prop governor is working. Now we're basically ready for takeoff. Final checklist. Got her. Waukegan Tower, Amphib, Caravan 18 Sierra Foxtrot's ready for takeoff.
Amphib 881 Sierra Foxtrot, Waukegan Tower, runway 23, clear for takeoff. Seat on course.
23, clear for takeoff. 8 Sierra Foxtrot. Everything looks pretty cool. Yep. Let's do it. All right, we're going to watch this three-fit. This is the torque or the turbine temperature. That's probably the number one thing we want to be watching for here is we want to get it up to that, not over red line, but right up there. watching for V1, which is just above 70. Rotation coming up. Right there. Now we can rotate. America's like right over there.
A great day to fly.
Yeah.
Visibility's awesome.
And we'll get on our heading here. Bringing the flaps up, our gear is up.
How long do you think our airtime will be?
I'll tell you. I'm guessing it'll be an hour and a half. Just looking, because we're in a climb showing two.
ETE?
Yeah, you can always see how much time's left with that.
Right.
So once we get above these clouds, we're going to be slower, but it's going to be really smooth. So I take smooth over slower.
Yeah.
Or smooth over faster. Any day. Living in the street.
Again? Oh, you're getting the big musky box?
Yeah.
Look at you.
Did you go off the right. Mojo Muskie. Mojo Muskie.
Mojo.
I've been down the Mississippi, down through New Orleans. Yes, I have. I've played in California. There ain't too much I haven't seen. Yes, I did. Got a girl in Cincinnati waiting where the Ohio River flows. Oh, girl, I'm a rambling man. Don't give your heart to a rambling man. You'd better move away. You're standing too close to the flame.
That's perfect.
We got Ron in the background.
Hold your arms up.
Woohoo!
Oh, yeah, that's
a nice
baby.
One.
That is nice.
Right.
Oh, that's a monster. Come on.
Yeah.
Wow.
Look at this, boy.
It's a monster. Look
That'd
at that.
That'd be 3-1.
Look at that. That is so long, Mabel. And that would be a 5+.
That's a fucking 5 pound.
That is a 5 pound plus, and that is not moving your hand up, arms up. Holy cow, look at that piece.
What's I miss with your mind? Your little heart won't beat the same. Oh, I'm a rambling man. Don't mess around with any old rambling man. Around.